Hi friends, today we are going to understand what are analog filter designs, and we will focus especially on Butterworth approximation filter design. So we will first analyze what do you mean by analog filter approximations, and then we will focus more on Butterworth filter approximation today. Now, for an analog filter, or for any filter rather, I have f on the x-axis and I plot the transfer function with respect to f. Okay, now for a filter, till the cutoff frequency, let's say that I have a low pass filter, that is LPF, so till the cutoff frequency, my filter should pass all the frequencies, and at the cutoff it should go to zero, and then it should remain zero thereafter. Okay, so filter will have this much as a pass band, and this, and after cutoff it will be a stop band. Pass band are the frequencies which are passed by the filter or by the system. Stop band are the set of frequencies which are not passed or rather are blocked by the filter. For example, if I will take a resistor and connect a capacitor, let's say to ground, and take the voltage with respect to ground over here and apply the voltage again with respect to ground over here as V in, and see the voltage at V out, and let's say the voltage is sinusoidal with various frequencies. So I have a knob over here which is which can be rotated in some direction to change the frequency. Let's say if I'm rotating in the clockwise direction, then my frequencies are increasing of the sinusoid. Now we know that XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. That means as the frequency will start increasing, my reactance will start decreasing. As the reactance will start decreasing, the capacitor will act more and more as a short circuit. So the output voltage across the capacitor will also be directly connected to ground. That means it will also act like a short circuit. So the output voltage will start decreasing with increase in the frequency. So if I consider this to be a system, then as the frequency increases, the output voltage decreases. So what will be the transfer function? Let's say the transfer function is V0 by Vin if I plot, V0 by Vin if I plot, modulus of it, let's say, then my V0 will start decreasing with frequency. So if I'm plotting this function over frequency, so this is my f and this is my V0 by Vin values for various values of f, then what will happen? As the frequency will start increasing, the VO will start decreasing. So it will be like this, isn't it? So this shows that the output or the transfer function decreases. So it passes certain frequencies, let's say it passes this many frequencies, and after that it will start reducing the output, and the output will reduce to zero at certain frequencies, and after that it will remain the zero whatever frequency you increase. So this structure or this system is a low pass filter. So the output voltage or the transfer function decreases with frequency. So this is also a one type of filter. This is a basic understanding of a filter, and this is how we practically built an analog filter. But it is really difficult to achieve this filter because the slope of this line is infinite. So we cannot achieve a practical filter with an infinite slope at cutoff. So what we do is we take an approximation. And the approximation deals like, I have f, I have h of f, magnitude, let's say. Then near the cutoff, let's say this is my cutoff, fc. What I'll do is, I'll keep the filter constant. Then I'll have, instead of infinite slope, I will keep some slope to the line. And then I will reach a minimum value. So what I got a starting value where the trail has started, and I got an ending value where my frequency has stopped, or where the attenuation is maximum. So this we called as a passband edge frequency, and this we called as a stopband edge frequency. And the cutoff frequency will be somewhere in between stopband and passband edge frequencies. Where exactly should be the location of cutoff frequency in this transition? So we have a passband edge, we have a stopband edge, and we have something called as a transition frequency, which we called as delta F, which is transition from passband to stopband. Now the cutoff frequency is occurring exactly at the value where I have a minus 3 dB, or we say that 3 dB down of the maximum value. Okay, so 3 dB down of maxima, so I should write here maxima h of f, whatever the maxima, I have to come 3 dB down of the maxima. If this maxima is 1, then this will be, of course, if this maxima is 0 dB, then it will be minus 3 dB. So let us not write this maxima, but it is 3 dB down. So we normally take cutoff frequency at 3 dB down from the maxima, okay, in the log scale. And in the absolute scale, it is AV by root 2, or we say that gain by root 2. That is the cutoff frequency value. So we have seen that we cannot achieve a practical filter with infinite slope. So we have approximated the slope, and this approximation has given me two new quantities. One is called as passband edge frequency, and one is called as a stopband edge frequency and a transition frequency. And the cutoff frequency will occur somewhere at a point where the gain has reached 3 dB, minus 3 dB value. This approximation, normally the filter approximations are done using two basic approximation method. One we called as a Butterworth approximation method, and second is we called as a Chebyshev approximation method. There is one more, which is called as elliptical approximation method. So today, let us focus more on Butterworth approximation method. So a Butterworth approximation method, if I plot a frequency versus h of f magnitude, then the Butterworth approximation method will look like this, or Butterworth approximation will look like this. So it will have an approximation going, let's say if this is my actual value, then this becomes my passband, this becomes my stopband. Okay, so my this are my ideal characteristics, and this is what my approximate characteristics are. In Butterworth approximation, we have no ripples, or we have a very smooth curve in the passband and in the stopband. So this curve will be very smooth in passband and in the stopband. Okay, so and we will keep the Butterworth filter to be very simpler. So let us draw the characteristics of a Butterworth filter that we will be using in the problem. So the characteristics is, let's say I write now radian frequency, that is omega, then my transfer function as a function of omega, its mod square. Now let us consider some parameters which will be called as the design parameters also for our case. So we have some value which have the maximum value. We will always normalize the filter to 1, we will always have a normalization factor as 1. Then we will have one more frequency, which we called as delta P, let's say. Okay. Then we have one more gain value. Let's say delta S. Okay. We have two frequencies. Omega P and omega S. Okay, and the characteristics will be, it will start from 1, then it will start trailing at the cutoff frequency. It will keep on trailing and will reach the delta S and will come out like this. Okay, now this frequency is called as a pass band. This is called as a pass band attenuation. This is called as stop band attenuation. This is called as pass band edge frequency, and this is called as stop band edge frequency. Okay, so we will be giving, or we will be getting, 4 characteristics from the user. One is called as pass band attenuation, stop band attenuation, pass band edge frequency, stop band edge frequency. And the transition in between passband and stopband is called as the transitional frequency. Okay, now at omega is equal to omega C. Okay, before going to omega C, let us understand that how we can get this, or how we can achieve this. So what is the approximation used? So the approximation of this is given as H A of omega mod square, let us keep it, equals to, let us normalize it, so I'll keep it 1 upon 1 plus omega by omega C the whole raised to 2 by n. This is the Butterworth approximation that we have used to obtain this curve, 1 upon 1 plus omega by omega C raised to 2n, where this n is called as the order, where n is called as the order of the filter. Now, as we can see that omega is equal to omega C, if I put omega equals to omega C, what will happen? This term will be 1, and 1 raised to any number is also 1. So we will be getting 1 upon 1 plus 1, which is equal to 0.5. So mod of HA square is 0.5. So wherever we find our curve reaching 0.5 value, okay, let's say it reaches here as 0.5, that frequency is considered to be the edge cutoff frequency. Okay, so this will be my cutoff frequency omega C. Wherever my curve will reach 0.5, that frequency I will consider as cutoff frequency, because at omega is equal to omega C, my HA of omega goes to 0.5. So that is what the characteristic will be given as. So we need to obtain, we will be given passband, stopband, edge frequencies and passband, stopband attenuation. Will not be told about the cutoff frequency. But we need to determine the cutoff frequency from these 4 parameters, and we need to also determine the order, because to obtain this curve, we need to obtain the order of the filter. So what we need to find is, in the design problem, we need to find the cutoff frequency and the order first. So these are the 2 basic parameters that we need to obtain to get the transfer function of the analog filter in a Butterworth approximation. So this is all about Butterworth approximation. Just to summarize, Butterworth approximation will be a smooth curve in both passband and stopband. It will have four characteristics: passband edge, stopband edge frequency, passband attenuation, stopband attenuation. Butterworth filter approximation looks like HA of omega, which is 1 upon 1 plus omega by omega c, the omega c the whole raised to 2n, where n is the order of the filter. To find if in a design problem four parameters are given, we need to find omega c and n. Now how does this n affects? This n affects on the order by, let's say if the n is, let's say this n is equal to 1, just for example, then I will have n is equal to 2, let's say, so it will come as a sharper steep slope. It will reach omega is equal to 1 and it will reach the cutoff faster. So this will be for n is equal to 2, let's say, then we have n is equal to 3, so it will also start at 1, reach the passband, reach this, and edge will be carried faster. That means you will, your stopband edge frequency will be shifted more towards cutoff frequency as the order goes high. So if I wanted more and more slope of the curve, or I want a very perfect kind of a filter, then I will make the transition width go smaller. To create the transition speed width go smaller, what I'll do is I will increase the order of the filter. Because all the orders will pass through this point, that is because at omega c n does not matters. That's why all the graphs, whether it is n is equal to 1 or 2 or 3 or any higher order, it will always pass through 0.5 value, because 0.5 value does not depend on n. So every graph has to pass through that 0.5 value. Only thing will happen is your cutoff, your stopband frequency will, or your stopband edge frequency will start shifting more and more towards the cutoff frequency as your order is increased. That means your slope becomes more and more steeper and you are approximating more towards the ideal characteristics. So this is all about Butterworth approximation of an analog filter. Thank you.